Hi, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. In this video, I'm going to teach you a simple, interesting, and relevant PowerPoint animation effect tutorial called New Year Rollover. The beautiful New Year Rollover effect you will learn today looks like this. Say from 2016, if I want to show the rollover to 2017, I show like this, and then 2017 to 2018 is like this. Let us watch this again. So that is the rollover effect you will learn today. I'm sure at this point, this tutorial comes quite handy. So let us jump right in and see how to create this beautiful effect from scratch. Here I am on a new slide. The first thing I'm going to do is to go to the Home tab, and from the text box in Auto Shapes menu, I am going to write the number 201. So this is the number that is going to be the precursor to the rolling over number here. So let us go here and let us give it a bold font. So the one that I'm going to use is called as Alpha Slab 1. You can use Arial Black. Any thick font would work quite nicely for this effect. Let us really increase the size of the font here. So this one looks just the right size. Now, once we have got the size and the font fixed, it is time to make a copy of this. So I'm going to press Ctrl D after selecting that particular number. And here I'm going to have just one number. So let us say I want to have this number as 6. Then I'm going to make a copy of this by pressing Ctrl D, and let us have this as say 7. And then let us have a copy of this by pressing Ctrl D and have this as number 8. So we are going to have number 6 leaving while 7 enters, and 7 leaving while 8 enters. So that is how the rollover effect is going to be. So what we are going to do is, first we are going to ensure that the number 6 is aligned properly with the rest of the numbers so that it looks like the year. Now I'm going to apply an animation. So let us go to Animation tab in PowerPoint ribbon, and the animation I'm going to use is a very simple exit animation, and it is called as flyout animation. And the direction of the flyout has to be to top. So that is the first one. And then while that exits, we need to have this number entering. So I'm going to select this, and I'm going to apply an animation called fly in animation, and it flies in from the bottom. So that is the next thing. So I'm going to have this right on top of the previous one. Just to ensure that everything is properly aligned, you can select everything, go to Home, Arrange, Align, and say Align Middle, and then Arrange, Align, Align Center. So those will ensure that the alignment is perfect. Now we need to ensure that the timing of the previous animation is proper. So let us go to the Animations tab and go to Animation Pane. I'm going to keep this slightly here so that it doesn't interfere with what I'm doing here. As you can see here, the two animation events are one where 6 exits and 7 enters. So this has to happen with previous. And then if the animation needs to be smooth, all we need to do is to ensure that the timing of the entry is half compared to the timing of the exit. So this duration is 0.5 seconds, and therefore the entrance duration has to be 0.25. So that is the one thing that you need to keep in mind. Now I'm going to do the next set of animations. Here number 7 leaves while 8 enters. So I have selected number 7 here, and I'm going to add an animation. Remember, if you choose any other animation here at this point, the earlier animation gets replaced. So don't do that. Go to add animation, and this time we are going to have fly out animation, and the direction of the fly out is to the top, which is in line with the earlier animation. And we need to have number 8 entering. So we need to select this, and then let us add a fly-in animation from the bottom. And let us have this also align on top, and make sure that all these numbers are properly aligned. And that is very important. And this entrance animation, as we mentioned earlier, needs to happen simultaneously. So we are going to say with previous, and the duration of the entrance animation has to be half that of the duration of the exit animation. So we have got 4 animation events here. The first one is 6. When 6 leaves in 0.5 seconds, that is, it flies out in 0.5 seconds, 7 enters in 0.25 seconds by way of fly-in. And that is the same thing that is repeated here. You can have as many numbers rolling in the same order. Now, the basic animation is pretty much done, but there is only one thing left, and that is to mask the fly-in and fly-out movement. Let me show you what I mean by that. First, let us see how this animation plays in the slideshow mode. Now, when I click, the 6 flies out here and then 7 flies in. Can you see here? And then 7 flies out and then 8 flies in. So this is how the animation is going to be. Now, as you can see here, the movement is very visible. We don't want that to happen. We need to mask that. So for that, all I'm going to do is to pick up a rectangle tool from the auto shapes menu, and I'm going to draw a rectangle. And I'm going to give it the color of the slide background. In this case, it is white. So I'm going to go to white and say no outline. And I'm going to make a copy of this by pressing Ctrl D. And I'm going to place this at the bottom as well, so that the movement from the bottom is also masked. So that is how these two bars exist. And now when we go to the slideshow mode, and when I click, 6 goes out and 7 rolls in, 7 goes out and 8 rolls in. So that is how you create a very simple New Year rollover animation effect in PowerPoint. If you like that simple animation, then you will find lots more in Ramgopal's PowerPoint Mastery program. In this program, we have more than 110 PowerPoint animation tutorials that help you understand PowerPoint animation in its entirety. This is one program that can really improve your skills in PowerPoint, especially if you're someone who uses PowerPoint for your business. So if you're a trainer, a consultant, a senior manager, a business owner, or anyone who uses PowerPoint for work, then please click on the link in the description box below the video and enroll into Ramgopal's PowerPoint Mastery program. And as a thank you for watching this video this far, I am happy to invite you to our 16 Snackable PowerPoint Tricks email course. This useful email course has 16 super short emails, each with a 30-second PowerPoint hack, which you can learn and apply in 30 seconds flat. These hacks will make your presentations look significantly better. You can enroll to this free course by clicking on the link here. So please click on the link, join 16 Snackable PowerPoint Tricks free email course, and I will see you inside.